upgrade your life, upgrade your network.
I be in a loop, she be in a group. Brody want a friend, throwing alley oop. Turn something to nothing, bro, I'm living proof. How can I lose when we do?
What's up, guys? It's your boy Eric Spofford. I'm hopping back on the channel, and today I want to talk to you about cash flow, financial freedom, and real estate. It's a topic that I know very well. It's been transformative to my life, and I realized recently that I haven't spent enough time on this very issue. Listen, when we talk about financial freedom, that word gets thrown around so much. Financial freedom. What does that mean? And how many people do you know have actually achieved financial freedom? Well, I'll tell you one thing, you know one, it's your boy. Listen, I wanna tell you a quick story about where I started my journey in real estate and what that looked like for me in the beginning, and then what it looks like today. In the beginning, 15 years ago, after working for several years and saving up some money with little assistance of my dad, as a 23-year-old young man, I purchased my first multifamily property. It was a 3-unit apartment building in a small town called Derry, New Hampshire. I did turn that into a sober living house, and so I maximized the rent roll that I was able to through starting the sober living business, which was intelligent at the time. But you do not need to do that to start. You do not need to be a sober living operator and start like I was, and I'm gonna teach you how to get into this game. What that meant for me at the time, I was 23 years old, I didn't have kids, I didn't have a family, I didn't have a big burn rate, I didn't own much, I had a used car. And I had a dog, and that was about my life, right? I was a few years sober from addiction, and I moved into, in this building, the smallest unit, and I rented the rest out. The cash flow that I was able to produce from that setup, from owning that real estate and living in the building, equaled this. I lived for free. This is the most, guys, I want you to understand this. This is the most important thing to establish to be able to build a good foundation for business, for financial freedom, and just for overall general life security, is find a way to lower or right size your monthly burn rate, what it costs you to live, and then have a goal of developing enough passive income or free cash flow that it pays this. And so you should live your life, and I have lived my life every single day for 15 years since I started that little sober living business in that piece of real estate, knowing that the money that I have coming in is gonna cover the money that I have going out. I wanna tell you, from a quality of life standpoint, from a stress management standpoint, from risk mitigation, from risk management, it's hard to rock my stuff, because I know no matter what, those checks are gonna hit the mailbox on the first, the bills are gonna get paid, and I'm gonna be all right. I can withstand a lot of storms, and I've had that freedom. Financial freedom really is about the word freedom. That is a lack of stress for 15 years now. And so I lived for free. I did not have to pay a rent. I didn't have to pay a light bill. I didn't have to pay for the oil to heat the place, because it's cold up north. And I also was able to turn a little bit of money. That money paid for my car, and it helped pay for some groceries and living expenses. And I was still working at the time. And so what that meant then is that all the money that I made in my paycheck and the earned income that I was making, I got to keep. I got to keep that money. And that's how I started to build. So the money, I established that financial freedom with a modest cost of life and that first building. And the money that I was making, I was able to keep. Because I didn't need to pay for my life, I was able to put that money into my business. I was able to save for my next real estate acquisition, etc. Fast forward to today, what does that mean? I have a commercial real estate portfolio that sometimes it's hard to remember all the assets that are in it. I have a portfolio of apartments, and my favorite, newest investment that I've been doing for the last, I don't even know how long, last little while, is single family Section 8 homes. I want to break down Section 8 homes a little bit for you and then tie it back into cash flow and financial freedom. Section 8 homes are so lucrative because it's backed by the federal government. And so they also pay more than market rate tenants. I'm buying homes in the Midwest and the South. I could teach you exactly what type of real estate to buy to get 30, 40, 50% cash on cash returns in some of my deals. I can't find that in commercial real estate, multifamily real estate, or any other area. It is the only place that I have seen returns like this. So now today I have this massive real estate portfolio that I've built, and I have rent checks coming in, and I have returns, and these things have compounded over time, and that pays for my life. As I build my life and my lifestyle, a lot of you have been following me for a long time. You remember when I bought the plane. You remember when I bought the jet. You remember when I bought the first place in Miami, and then I upgraded to the second place in Miami, and then I upgraded to the house I'm in now, my third place in Miami. What I didn't share with you is that all behind the scenes, I was growing my real estate investments and growing my cash flow and my passive income, that I knew that I could afford these things because I had money coming in to pay for them. Listen, I want all of you, I mean this, all of you to experience financial freedom. The amount of people I see struggle, that they have to make their bills every month, and they work a job, they work two jobs, they try to hustle, or they're growing a business and they're barely getting by. You know, it's just crazy when it doesn't have to be like that if you have the proper coaching, mentor, and guidance and information to grow a real estate portfolio, right size your burn rate, right size your cash flow, and build from there. The other amazing thing about real estate is it's for life. You own that building, you own that home. You can drive up to it and there's my money, I know where it is. It appreciates over time. Real estate is always, over any period of time, considerable period of time, it is worth more, it is never worth less. If you look at real estate over time, it goes up and down, but the entire time, it's cruising upward, right? There's also amazing tax benefits to real estate, which I can get into another time, but it's around depreciation and becoming a real estate professional and offsetting the expense of the real estate. You can classify the depreciation of your real estate as an expense, and if you do it properly and are working in real estate, you can use that against your earned income. And if not, you can still write down the expense of it against your passive income. And it's an asset that pays you to own it. You can buy into the stock market, and most products in the stock market don't pay you monthly to own it. You can also use bank financing. You can have leverage. Think about the smartest people in the world control the money, right? The smartest people in the world that are really behind the scenes controlling business, controlling real estate, are the banks. The banks will not lend you money to buy stocks in a business, but they will lend you money to buy real estate. Interesting. And the other benefits are it's for life. Guys, once you set it up, the rents continue to increase in Section 8 to give you a 5 to 8% typically increase year over year for perpetuity, until the end of time. I sleep like a baby knowing that if anything happens to me, God forbid, this is a crazy world, but if anything happens to me, my two boys, my sons, they're covered. My real estate will be my legacy. It will continue to feed them, put food on their table. It will go to my grandchildren. It will go to my great-great-grandchildren. That is called building generational wealth. You can do that now. You can start with one home. I can teach you how to get your first Section 8 property using creative financing with very little money, if any money at all, down. There are strategies to do such. Listen, below in the description of this video is a link for my course, my educational system, where I'm gonna teach you everything that I know about real estate. Take the opportunity. The most frustrating thing is watching people lose time because they're scared. It's such a broke mindset that people think it's a scam to invest in themselves. People never get off the bench and get in the game, and they sit and watch things. How long have you been saying you're gonna do it? How long have you been curious about real estate? How long have you been wanting to get rich, building wealth? How long? You gotta start. You gotta be on the offense, not the defense. You can't sit there and kick yourself in the ass for another year wasted, another year you didn't get in the game. You have to get in the game and get all offense, put one foot in front of the other, and move forward, and we're here to do that together. So God bless, I appreciate you. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching the video. We're gonna win together. Listen, if you enjoyed this video, please share it with somebody, like it, and leave a comment, and subscribe to the channel. Stay solid. Goodbye, my personal brand. I'm so sorry, guys.